In last class, we were discussed about what is key, types of keys. And today, we are going to discuss about in types of keys. So that is, we were discussed about types of sun keys. What is a sun key? So sun key is nothing but the keyways in shaft and hub. Then it is called a sun key. The key is inserted in shaft and hub. So that is called sun key. So half of the key is in the hub and half of the key is in the shaft. So then that is called sun key. Now, so actually what is key? Key is nothing but keys used to stop the relative motion between shaft and hub. So that the shaft can transmit full torque to the hub. So the, for that purpose, we are used keys. Keys are positive way of transmitting the power. So there is no loss of power in between shaft and hub using the key. So here we are discussing about, in this class we are discussing about types of saddle keys and design of sun keys. So here first we were discussing about the saddle keys. What is a saddle key? So as I said, so the keyway is in the hub. When the keyway is in the hub and shaft, then it is called sun keys. Whereas in the keyway is only in the hub, there is no keyway in the shaft. So then it is called saddle keys. So here slot will be in the only in the hub. There is no slot in the key shaft. So the types of saddle keys are hollow saddle key and square saddle key, flat saddle key. So first we'll see the hollow saddle keys. So as I said, saddle keys are having keyway only in the hub, means the key is inserted only in the hub. There is no provision to insert the key in the shaft. So then it is saddle key. For hollow saddle keys, requires keyway in the hub and the underside of the key is covered to suit the shaft. So here it has a key at the bottom of the key is having the shape of the shaft like circular shape so that it can insert, it can place exactly as the shaft. So that the key is having a curve at the bottom side, then it is called hollow saddle key. And tapered on the top and transmit torque pure by friction only. Here the torque is transmitted only by friction. So because it is not in the keyway is not in the shaft, so that's why here the power transmission is purely by friction only. In hollow saddle keys, so the slot only in the hub. So that's why the key is inserted into the hub. For hollow saddle key, the bottom of the hub is in the curved shape as a shaft is having. So here, the torque is transmitted by shaft is purely friction because there is no slot in the shaft. So that's why it is used for light loads. So it is suitable for only light loads. So if high load is applied, there is a chance of slip. So that's why it is only applicable for the light loads only. So next one is flat saddle keys. It requires a keyway in the hub. As I said, the flat saddle key, so this is the hollow saddle key. The bottom of the key is having in the curve shape as like a shaft so that it can be easily go into the slot. So for the flat saddle keys, what happens is, so it is a same as hollow saddle key. It requires a keyway in the hub. This is a flat saddle key. and corresponding flat on the shaft. So when bottom of the key is like flat, straight. So here it is used for very light loads. So, but it has a greater driving than the saddle keys. So it has a small contact to the shaft. So that's why there is a more chance of slip. So that's why it is used for very, very light loads. So as I said, saddle keys are having a slot only, keyway only in the hub. So, and the for hollow saddle key, the bottom of the key is in the curve shape, whereas the for the flat saddle key, bottom of the key is like flat. So when it touches to the shaft, it is only line contact. So that is a flat saddle key. It is used for very, very light loads. So this is flat saddle key and this is hollow saddle key. So next we are coming to the design of funkies. So design of funkies, keys support parts such as gears, pulleys on the shafts, which are subjected to torque. So the stresses in the key are induced by the following forces. One is force due to fitting the key in the keyway. So where the force is used to fit the key into the keyway. So it may be hammered to fit exactly into the keyway so that it has a tight fit. So that force due to fitting of key in the keyway. And forces that are caused by torque transmitted. So this is the very important one. Force that are caused by the torque transmitted. When it is transmitting from, torque is transmitting from shaft to hub. So the forces exerted, we need to consider. So because of complexity, an exact analysis of stresses usually cannot be made. So it has a complexity that an exact analysis of stresses cannot be made because half of the key is in the hub, half of the key is in the shaft. So because of the complexity, we cannot exactly assess the stresses developed. And it is assumed that entire torque is carried by the tangential force located at the shaft surface and the force along the length of the key. So here we will only consider that the total stress is, the total force is located at the shaft surface. So where the shaft and hub touches that surface, on the surface only force, tangential force is located, and the force along the keyway is uniform. Along the keyway is uniform. There is no variation from one place to another. Total length of the key is the same. Uniform force is applied along the length of the key. So here, key transmit torque from shaft to sleeve or flange. It is subjected to considerable crushing and shear stresses and may fail in the following ways. Some of the points are, so key may fail because of torque transmission to the hub from shaft to hub. So here we consider crushing and shear stress. So as I said, tangential force is located at the surface of the shaft. So then the key may fail because of shearing and crushing. So the two stresses will be developed, that is shearing stress and crushing stress. Key may fail due to shear stress and crushing stress. So where it is on the surface of the shaft. So key may fail due to shearing and crushing. And the designers usually confirms to Indian standard recommendations on the width and thickness of the key. And required length is calculated by considering shear strength and crushing strength of key. So here we design the key based on the, we design the key, that is design of key is nothing but we need to find the width, thickness and length based on shear strength and crushing strength. So the key should not fail because of the shear stress or crushing stress. So to obey the shear strength and crushing strength, based on these two, we need to calculate the width, thickness and length of the key. So final design of the key is nothing but we need to find the length, thickness and width of the key. Length, thickness and width. So these are the designing of the shaft. So these based on what means? Based on the shear strength and crushing strength. Because key may fail due to the shear stress or crushing stress. So the area should resist to the crushing and area should resist to the shearing. So in both the cases, stresses induced in key is greater than the permissible value in crushing and shearing respectively. So while considering the strength of the key, it is customary to neglect forces due to fit of key in keyway. So here we neglect the forces which are used to fit the key into the keyway. So we need to neglect that force because the torque is more than the fitting force. So that's why we neglect the forces due to fit of key in the keyway. So here we need to consider two strengths. One is shear strength and crushing strength for design of shaft. Design of shaft is nothing but we need to design width, thickness and length of the key. So when you see the picture here, as I said, the force is, tangential force is applied only on the, we are assuming that the applied force is only on the surface of the shaft, on the key where it touches shaft and hub. So here this is the surface of the key, so that at this place only the for tangential force is applied, that we are assuming. So here, and it has a uniform load along the length of the key. So first we are considering crushing strength and shear. Both what we consider is crushing strength and shearing strength. So it may fail due to the crushing and shearing of the key. Key may fail due to crushing and shearing. So in this way, the key is subjected to crushing stress and shearing stress. So here, crushing area we need to consider. So this is the key. Key has width, thickness and length. We need to find width, thickness and length of the key here. So when shaft is subjected to torque T, the tangential force will act F in this way and F at it this way. So here crushing area equal to, here this is the crushing area on the surface of the shaft, that is this length L into this . So this is the, this part will get crushing. So this part may get crushed. So this part is nothing but this length into. So this is the total thickness is T. Half of the thickness is T by 2. So here crushing area is T by 2 into L. So this area will get it crushed. So this is crushing area. So next we'll go for the shearing area. Shearing area is, so this part may get shear off, cut on the surface of the shaft. So thus area of shearing is, so this total length will get crush into this width, that is W. That is W into L. So shearing area is W into L, whereas crushing area is T by 2 into L. So area resisting crushing is T by 2 into L. Area resisting shear is W into L. So this is very important for the design of shaft. So crushing area is T by 2 into L, shearing area is W into L. So this surface will get shear off, so that's why that is W into L. This much of thickness of the area of key may crush, that's why T by 2 into L. So first, T equal to torque to be transmitted, that is Newton mm, and shear stress induced in K is tau, that is Newton per mm square. Sigma C equal to compression stress induced, and that is also Newton per mm square. D is the diameter of the shaft in mm, and W is width of the key in mm, and T is thickness of key in mm, and L is length of the key is in M. So by considering shearing strength and crushing strength, we need to find the width, thickness and length of the key. So first strength of the key, that is shear strength of the key. Considering shear strength of the key, torque equal to force into radius of a shaft. Torque is nothing but Newton mm, that is force into radius of the shaft. Here we are considering shear force. So that's why here considering shear strength, the force is shear force. The shear force is shear stress into shear area. So radius of the shaft is D by 2. So here shear force is shear stress into shear area into radius of the shaft is D by 2. Shear stress is tau, shear area is W into L. Into D by 2. Torque equal to shear stress into shear area is W into L into D by 2 is the torque of the key, torque to be transmitted. So considering shear strength, T equal to tau into W into L into D by 2. So considering the crushing stress here, so now here torque will be 2T by WLD. So first we will consider shear stress, shear strength, then torque equal to tau into WL into D by 2. So now here shear stress equal to 2T by WLD. So while considering the crushing strength, torque equal to crushing force into radius of the shaft. So crushing force equal to crushing stress into area and compression into D by 2. So compressive stress equal to sigma c, area in compressive equal to area is in compressive or crushing is T by 2 into L. T by 2 L into D by 2. Then torque equal to sigma c into TL into D by 4. So here sigma c equal to 4T by TLD. Crushing stress equal to 4T by TLD. So whereas shear stress equal to 2T by WLD. So the individual stresses are computed by equation 1 and 2 and should not exceed the permissible values. So those shear stress and crushing stress and shearing stress should not exceed the permissible value of the shear key shearing and compressive stresses. So if the key is equally strong in shearing and crushing, then the permissible crushing stress for the usual key material is at least twice the permissible shearing stress. So permissible crushing stress of the usual key material is at least twice the permissible shearing stress. So if it is happened when W equal to T, in other words, if the square key is equally strong in shearing, then crushing stress of the key is at least twice the permissible shearing stress. So if W equal to T, sigma c equal to 2 into tau. For square key, then W equal to T, then the permissible crushing stress for usual key material is at least twice the permissible shearing stress. Sigma c equal to 2 into tau for the square key. So here the key is equally strong in shearing and crushing. Here the key is equally strong in for the square key T equal to W, then sigma c equal to 2 into tau. Square steel key is equally strong in shearing and crushing. equally strong in shearing and crushing for Squeaky. The proportions of rectangular Sankey is, so the usual proportions are given as width of the key equal to d by 4. So width is d by 4 and thickness is d by 6. 2/3 of W, that is equal to d by 6. Thickness of the key is d by 6 and width of the key is d by 4 in usual cases for the rectangular Sankey. For square, it is d by 2 d by 4 for the width of the key and thickness of the key is d by 6. So here d is the diameter of the shaft. The key has a taper 1 in 100 on the top side only. For rectangular and square key, it has a taper that is 1 is to 100 on top side only. The required length of the key may be obtained by equating the strength of the key to the shaft strength. So we need to get the length of the key to obtain a length of the key, we need to equate the strength of the key equal to the strength of the shaft. So strength of the shaft is nothing but torque equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau. So whereas the resisting torque of key equal to WL into tau into d by 2. So when you equate both of them, WL into tau into d by 2 equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau. So here, if the shaft and key is of same material, tau get cancelled. And W equal to d by 4, when you substitute the W equal to d by 4, then length of the key equal to pi d by 2, that is 1.571 d. To get the length of the shaft, we need to equate strength of the shaft to the strength of the key. So strength of the torque transmitted by shaft equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau and resisting torque of key equal to WL into tau into d by 2. By equating these two, if the key is made of same material as shaft, tau get cancelled, whereas substituting W equal to d by 4, then length is equal to pi d by 2. So in this chapter, we were studied about the types of saddle keys and design of Sankey. So types of saddle keys are, one is hollow saddle key and flat saddle key. So saddle keys are having a keyway only in the hub. So that is saddle keys. Hollow saddle key, so bottom of the key is having the curved shape as the shaft. Whereas the flat saddle key, bottom of the key is flat. So that is types of saddle keys. So design of Sankey. In design of Sankey, we need to design the key That is width, thickness and length of the key we need to design based on the shearing strength and crushing strength of the key. So by considering shearing strength and crushing strength, we need to find the width, thickness and length of the key. So here we need to consider that the total tangential forces acting on the surface of the shaft. So there has shear stress and crushing strength. And it is uniform throughout the length of the key. Then based on those considerations, we need to design the Sankey. So first, in the considering Sankey, what are the forces applied is the force due to the torque and the force which is used to fit the key into the keyway. So in designing a Sankey, we need to neglect the force which is used to fit the key into the key, and we need to consider the torque here to design any key. So the keyway cut into the shaft reduces the strength of the shaft due to stress concentration. So here the strength of the keyed shaft is taken as 75% of the strength of the solution. So when you are cutting the keyway into the key, into the shaft, what happens is the strength of the key will be reduced because the area will be less. So the stress concentration will be more at the place where the area is less. So that's why there the stress concentration is more. The strength of the keyed shaft is taken as 75% of the solid shaft. It reduces to the 75%. So we'll see some quiz questions. The distribution of stress along the length of the key fitted in the shaft is exponential shape, being more at the torque input end. So it is more exponential shape. So it is complicated shape because being more at the torque input end. So next one is a flat saddle key. Options are, is provided in the hub only and hollow to fit the shaft, has flat surface, the shaft is machined to fit the key, and none of the above. So questions, explain the saddle keys. Mention the design criteria of keys. What are the various stresses considered in design of keys?